like there's certain places where I want to get to in my life that I look at right now and I'm like, damn, like how am I gonna get there? Like,
I don't understand. You said you'd never leave. You told me that you'd be there, but you're letting it to me. You're always on my mind, and when it's late at night, I think of what you're doing. Do you think of me sometimes? And when I'm feeling down, I lose all control. Emotions keep coming out. I'm trying to let you go. So if you wanna talk to me again. Don't try to act like we were always friends.
Picnic, and my lashes are so annoying right now, y'all. I'm gonna talk to you guys when I get there. There's some things that I want to talk to you guys about, so can't wait to get into it with y'all.
You my job, baby girl, yeah, I'm on my way.
So I'm at the park right now, but I don't know why, y'all, but I couldn't find the address of this park I went to like last month. I went to this park and it was just such a nice freaking park. Like, I don't know, but now I found this little park and I'm just here because I didn't know where else to go and I don't live around here, so I was like, I'm just gonna find me a different park and just find like a cute little green spot. And I feel like around here is kind of nice because it's kind of empty, so I'm just gonna go in there, set up, like find a little spot, and then I'm gonna get back to y'all. I don't think I'm gonna take all my stuff out just yet. I'm gonna just go with my I'm gonna just walk around and see, scope the scenery out real quick, and then once I find a spot, then I'm gonna get back to you guys. This is such a cute park, and it's so empty. I love it. Guys, I've been meaning to come to the park like so much lately. Like, I've just been wanting to connect with nature. I don't know, for some reason, like, it just feels like nature is giving me a hug. Like, I just love nature so much. I really do. Like, every single place that I go, I have to take a picture of like anything green. If it looks pretty and green, I just like, it makes me happy. But yeah, I'm a little tired right now. I'm still walking, trying to find a spot, but I think that I'm just gonna sit on those benches over there and call it a day, because I was trying to sit and yeah, I think I'm just gonna go sit over there because it looks the most safest to me. As much as I love nature, I am scary and I don't want to see nothing out of the ordinary, so I'm just gonna go sit over there and keep it cute. And it's still like a cute little background and scenery for you guys to enjoy while we discuss some things, but I think that I'm gonna sit over there. So sit over there, y'all.
I wish y'all could answer me. I would love that. Or actually, I could probably sit over here on the floor, set up, and just sit there. That'd be nice. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Jerusalem, for those of you guys that are new here, and I am 20. On this channel, y'all, we learn to navigate our 20s together. And just, you guys get to experience life with me, life of my 20s, you know, as somebody who is navigating just life, honestly. That's really what my channel is about. And so if you guys are new here, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel, because I definitely will have more content like this coming soon. This is not like the type of content that I usually make, y'all, but like this is the type of content that I want to make for my channel. Before I got cut off, I was saying like this is not the type of content that I usually make for my channel, but this is what I'm trying to get into, like just being vulnerable on camera and just kind of like speaking my mind, I guess, because I don't know, y'all, I feel like there's a lot of people that could definitely learn from you just sharing your feelings and just speaking your mind, and this will also just help me just literally let it out. And like, I'm such a private person and things like that, so that's why I always kind of like take a step back from doing videos like this. Like, there's so many videos where I've sat down, like been intentional about it, and like went out of my way and filmed stuff, but it's like at the end, like I don't feel comfortable being vulnerable to random people, but it's like that's just what it is, and I have accepted that because YouTube is something that I want to do. It's something that I enjoy doing, you know, sharing my personal life and just sharing what I'm going through. Like, I'm not afraid to share that at all. Like, I don't care. But yeah, guys, that's what my channel is about. So if that's something that you're interested in, make sure to tap in, subscribe, like, comment, all of that. You already know what to do. I already gotta tell you over and over again. I hope not. But yeah, guys, so I'm just setting up right now. I just got here. This wasn't even the park I originally wanted to come to, but I found this one and I was like, hey, here we are. There's this one other park that I went to, but that's okay. It don't matter. Anyways, in today's video, I just kind of wanted to speak to you guys. Sorry, y'all, I'm gonna be looking all over the place. I don't know, because I'm just trying to pull up some things. But, and y'all, oh, I got me some acai bowls, so I'm about to bust down on this. You already know the vibes. I got Playa bowls. If y'all don't know, Playa bowls are the best. Got the best acai bowls, so go tap in. I gotta do my thumbnail before I look rough. But today, y'all, I brought my journal. I have this book. I don't know which book I wanted to read, so I brought both books. We'll see which one we go with. And I brought my prayer journal because I just want to sit here and let some things out, because I feel as though that will help. Like, it definitely does. Every time I pray and just talk to God about some things that I'm going through in my life, I just come back so much stronger. And I have realized in my life, like, He's the only person that's gonna be there for me, honestly, y'all. And that's also kind of what I want to touch up on this video. Like, I don't even know where to start. So, y'all, navigating your 20s is not easy at all. And, like, I just want to come on here and just be, like, you know, be transparent and just share some things that I've learned with you guys so far. I'm only 20, and, like, I feel like I've learned a lot of things so far. And, you know, somebody might be going through some things that I previously went through. And so I just kind of want to just share with you guys some things, and hopefully, like, it helps you navigate you know, the hardship that's going on in your life, or just anything that's going on, honestly. But y'all, like, 20s are so not consistent at all. Like, your 20s are gonna be the most inconsistent
time of your life, y'all. Like, it really is. And it's in this time that you learn not to give up, that you learn to push yourself through whatever comes in your life, like whether that's a mental block, whether that's, you know, like real life physical situations or just anything that goes on. Like, I feel like this is when we really learn to push through it, navigate through it, and, you know, find ways to cope with it. And that's what I've been learning. And it's kind of been hard also because, you know, when you don't have somebody to sit down with you and teach you, like, you know, like, this is what it is, this is what it is, it's gonna be 10 times harder. And that's what you have to realize. You have to realize that you're a special person. You're not like everybody else, you know? Like, you know, a lot of people are very fortunate in their life to have somebody help them through some things when they go through stuff mentally. Like, that's truly a blessing to have somebody sit there, comfort you, and just be there for you whenever you need anything. Like, that's something really big. Like, it's not spoken about enough nowadays. In 2024, everybody's worried about their image. Nobody wants to be vulnerable. Nobody wants to be there for each other. Everybody wants to go get the bag. Hey, I want to get the bag too, but like, for me, I feel like if I'm not happy within myself, like, everything else is just extra to me. Like, as much as that kind of sounds fake, it doesn't sound real, like, that's just what it is. And honestly, I've learned so much things as far as, like, just expecting things from people. And this is coming from somebody that was just a people pleaser. And this video's probably just gonna be all over the place, by the way, because I'm just sharing some things that I'm going through, and I'm just telling you guys not to give up in whatever you're going through right now. So I'm just gonna be, you know, jumping into topics, or just, I might be talking about some things, and it's just probably gonna be all over the place. But yeah, like, you know, not everybody has those people around to help them through all these things that go on in life. And, you know, like I said, for me, like, that's just whatever, everything else is just extras. If I'm happy within myself, if everybody else is around me is happy and everything, like, I'm truly happy. Like, I really am. That's all that I need. Like, if I have such a great relationship with God, if I'm being consistent with everything that I have going on, like, it makes me truly happy. But, you know, of course, that's not to say, like, real life situations don't bother me, real life situations don't affect me at all. Like, I'm human, like, they do, you know. Like, there's certain places where I want to get to in my life that I look at right now and I'm like, damn, like, how am I gonna get there? Like, you know, you just feel so lost. Like, just when you feel like you have it figured out, you're back to step one. And it's just like a frustrating thing because you don't know, like, you don't know what it is, and you just have to keep going because it's not, there's no guide to life, and there's no, you know, nobody's holding your hand, guiding you, telling you this is what you need to do. There's construction going on over there. It's so annoying. But, you know, like, you don't have anybody, like, sitting there with you, like, telling you it's gonna be okay at every single step of your life, because everybody got their own life going on at the end of the day. Everybody has something they're going through right now. Like me right now, I'm sitting here talking to you guys, and I myself, I'm battling through some things in my life. This is my world. You guys are getting a glimpse of my life right now, and you are getting to experience, you know, my life with me and things like that. So everybody, like, it's everybody's world. Like, you can't, you know, just because it's your world, and, like, for you, you feel like it's your world and everything should go your way, and, you know, you feel like people should be there for you, like, that's probably how other people feel as well. Like, that's just the truth. Like, you know, you just have to realize, like, you can't seek comfort from other people. You just can't. Like, you have to work within yourself to kind of be there for yourself no matter what, you know. And I'm saying that as a people pleaser because, you know, sometimes you have expectations for people to, like, stand up for you, be there for you when you're going through stuff. Like, you might feel like, damn, like, what the fuck? Like, I'm going through all these things and nobody is here to help me do these things. Like, I have to push myself. And honestly, like, that's just a sad reality of it. Like, it's like, as much as humans have to communicate their feelings, they have to speak up on their issues, things, like, just share their thoughts, feelings, to, you know, they just gotta let it out. As much as we have to do that, what else you can be vulnerable with, or just, you know, be comfortable sharing your feelings with, like, then you have to be the one there for yourself. Like, if you feel as though there's nobody in your life that can be there for you to help you through your situations in life, your mental blocks in life, like, you have to be the one there for yourself, and nobody's coming to save you, honestly. Like, nobody's coming to save you, y'all. Like, as soon as I turned 18, I feel like life, I just, like, was thrown into adulthood, and not a bad thing, but you just realize, like, the world is just an evil place. Like, and I'm not even saying that to be, like, so negative and talk bad about society and everything, but that's just the truth. Like, like, I'm just being real. Everybody has things they're battling with. Everybody has situations they got going on in their life. So, like, and whatever you're going through, you have to find ways to cope with it, whether that's reading books, whether that's, you know, continuing to push every day. Like, y'all, keep pushing every day. Keep pushing every day, y'all. Like, do not give up, because your breakthrough might be tomorrow and you don't even know it. Like, you might give up today and your breakthrough might be tomorrow. Do not give up, bro. Like, that's one thing. No matter what happens, bro, like, that thing is trying to teach you a lesson in your life. That thing is trying to teach you something that you need to know in the moment. Like, just recognize that and understand that. And, like, in the moment, of course, it's going to be so hard. Like, no matter whatever the situation is, like, of course, it's going to be so hard to navigate through. It's going to be so hard for you to, like, keep that positive mindset, positive attitude of whatever's going on. But that's why you got to push yourself, you know, like, just pray to God. Like, honestly, like, if you don't think that things are not going your way, just write down your thoughts, write down your feelings, and, you know, find solutions for them, because sitting here crying about situations is not going to change anything. Sitting here being sad, trying to find sympathy from other people, trying to find, you know, validation from other people, it's just not going to do anything, because what's the point anyways? It's your life. Like, why do you need that from other people? Like, nobody's coming, like, nobody's gonna hold your hand, show you every single step, because that's just, that's not gonna add the love. I'm sorry, it's not. But no matter whatever you're going through right now, it's gonna pass. Like, trust me, it's gonna pass. Like, sometimes I think about, like, I'd be like, there's been times where, like, I'm gonna be sitting here right now, and later I'm gonna be home. Just like that, it's gone. So it's like, just enjoy the moment and try to, you know, be positive in the moment and just push yourself through that moment, because it's only there for a moment. And don't let it discourage you, because, y'all, I'm telling you, the enemy, the devil, whatever you want to call it, will come in your life trying to distract you in every single way possible. In every single way possible. Like, in ways you won't even expect, dude. Like, in ways you won't even expect. Could be whether, do it is, woo! That's an ant. Ooh, I don't want to kill them. I'm in their space. I don't like this. But, like I was saying, damn, I forgot what I was saying. Just recognize that nothing is meant to last forever. That you just gotta enjoy it for the moment, appreciate it, be grateful for it, take whatever lesson the thing is trying to teach you from it, and just move on with your life, because we can't be stuck on a situation that's only meant to bring us down. You know, like I said, the devil works in all ways. It works in all ways possible. It wants to discourage us so bad. It doesn't want us to see what God has for us and what God has for us on the other side. So, see, even now, like, where did that shit come from? Like, it doesn't want to see what God has for us, like, on the other side. So,
continue to push through whatever you're going through in your life. It's all gonna pass, babes. And if y'all ever, like, you know, if y'all ever need anybody to reach out to, speak to, be vulnerable with, like, y'all, my email is always open, my Instagram is always open. Like, I love being able to relate with others. I love being able to hear other people's stories, because I feel like I learn a lot more as well. Because for me in life, it's all about perspective, and, you know, just like, just changing the way you see things and allowing it to like lessons, instead of, you know, discouraging you, or instead of, like, I don't know, just keep pushing though. Like, I know that. And if you guys ever need anybody to, like, speak to or anything like that, like I was saying, just make sure you hit me up. Like, I'll always be here to listen. Like, even if I can't tell you what it is, you know, sometimes we need people to speak to, we need people to be vulnerable with, we need people to just, you know, share our thoughts with, because we're humans. Like, we can't hold on things for too long. And I know, like, not a lot of people have people they can share, you know, their situations with, their life problems with, or just, like, anything in general. So if y'all ever feel that way, like, feel free to text me, you know. I'm definitely open to just hearing people's life stories and just anything, and be able to help in any way, even if that's just by lending an ear or anything like that. So I just want you guys to know that I'm always open for that. That being said, like, feel free to hit me up. But yeah, and y'all, like, just stop having expectations for people. That's one thing also I'm learning, you know, like, just stop having expectations for people. It's not gonna do nothing, love. It's all gonna lead them to disappointment. You have to stop thinking everybody's like you, because not everybody's like you. Like, just because you have such a good heart, just because, oh my gosh, this freaking ant, just get the fuck out my freaking way, yo. Like, just because you have a good heart, just because you're a loving person, doesn't mean the other person is just like you. So just recognize that. Of course, see the good in people always, but don't have any high expectations, because that's when you get disappointed and hurt your own feelings, and then you start to feel like you're not worthy of anything. You start to feel like, you know, like, you're not meant for this life, and just all things negative. So this life stuff is, it's just the way you go about it, and just finding that path. Because once you learn how this life game works, then, like, nothing will disappoint you anymore. And honestly, like, after I graduated high school, I feel like I've learned so much and, like, changed as a person. And what I'm going through right now is that, like, I have gotten rid of that past self of mine, and I have just become this. Like, I am in a phase of my life where I am teaching myself things, and I am growing to the person that I am meant to be, and I'm learning my purpose all over again. Because, you know, when I was a kid, of course, like, all my experiences and just whatever I would go through was because of whatever I experienced in society, and, like, just hearing other people's perspectives. And now, like, you get to experience life for yourself. So, you know, sit down, write down what you want from this life, and always continue to push, because as long as you continue to push, like, there's gonna be progress. It's only when you don't push, when you give up, there's gonna be no progress, and, like, everything just leads to disappointment. But as long as you're trying, as long as you're being good to people, you know, good karma will always come to you. Like, even though your situation right now might not seem like it, like, it's definitely gonna happen for you, love. And I just want you guys to know that, like, just focus on yourself and cut out the outside world. Like, cut out the outside world. Because at the end of the day, people will come to you when they need something, and when you need them, they're not there for you, and it leads to disappointment. But it's like, you know, everybody's selfish. Everybody got things they're going through. You can't be selfish and think about just yourself. Like, of course, for you, it's your world, but for other people, it's not. It's their world. You're in their world, and they're in your world, in their eyes. So it's like,
you know? It's just all about perspectives and just recognizing that you're not the only one who needs to be cared for, loved for, and just need to be heard, because everybody's going through the same thing, and you just gotta continue to push and keep loving on yourself. You be what other people couldn't be for you. And when you love yourself so hard, when you push yourself so hard, when you continue to see the good in the world, even though whatever is showing us is just all negatives, good things will come to you. And you should know that good things are there, and good things are real in the world, because you're an example. You literally are. So you guys just understand and recognize that, for one, nobody cares in this life. Nobody's gonna save you. Stop trying to please people. Don't give a fuck about what anybody has to say about your life. Nobody pays your bills. Nobody's guiding you through this life. You gotta be there, the one for yourself. You gotta be there for yourself. You gotta push for yourself. You gotta stand up for yourself. And you gotta build that confidence, strength within yourself. When you do that, nobody can fuck with you. Nobody can fuck with you at all, trust me. And trust me, like, nobody can fuck with you. And yeah, honestly, that's just kind of like what I wanted to touch bases on, because like these past couple days or these past couple weeks has just been like a very, like, it's been like, I'm happy, but it's like, it feels like every day is a different emotion. Just when I feel like I know what's going on, it's like I'm 10 steps backwards. So it's like, it feels like I'm not getting nowhere. And the fact that the things that I want in my life, the fact that, like, and honestly, it's also social media as well, because I never used to compare myself at all, but sometimes we're human. It's human nature to compare yourself, and just, I guess, just focus on the negatives and focus on what we don't have. And it's sad, but you know, we have to learn to be more grateful, be more appreciative of whatever we have, because that's when more things will come in our life. We have to recognize, we have to keep that high vibrational mode, and we have to keep going no matter whatever is going on, no matter whatever is thrown at us. And yeah, guys, like, there's definitely more lessons I want to tell you guys, but this video is probably just all over the place because I didn't, like, have a list for what I wanted to talk about. There was just some things that was on my mind that I wanted to share, because, y'all, like, it's been so hard navigating these past couple days. And for me, like, I'm such a personal person. Like, I don't like sharing my feelings with just everybody. So I'd rather just hold it in, write my thoughts down, you know, journal and things like that. So I feel like I am my own healer, and you can be that for yourself as well, and you can go out there and help people and, you know, just navigate through life, and you can be the one to stand alone and be that bitch, for real. And yeah, that's just all I really wanted to say. I'm just gonna go journal really quickly, and I'm gonna eat my acai bowl, and I'm just gonna chill here for a little and just think and reflect on life and things like that. So yeah, I'll definitely be doing more videos like this, because this was fun. Like, I went for a walk in the morning, and it was just a cool little thing to do. So I can't wait to do it again, and I can't wait to come connect with nature, because it feels like I'm getting a hug right now. I swear to God, like, I'm in the middle of, like, I'm just sitting on the floor, and it's just all trees all above me, and I just feel so loved and appreciated. I really do. Damn, my nipples are hard. I don't like that. But yeah, guys, I'm gonna end this right here. I'll probably talk to you guys more later, but for right now, I'm gonna go eat my food. I'm gonna go journal. So see you later, babes. I hope you got something from this video, and I just want you to know, keep pushing, keep loving on yourself. As long as you do that, you'll get somewhere, I promise you, because negative thoughts are not an option. Fuck that shit. It's gonna happen for you. Whatever it is, it's gonna happen for you. And all of this is just some things you gotta go through to get to where you wanna be. And that's just what you have to recognize. Stop being sad. Stop trying to find sympathy from other people. Stop trying to make people sad for you, because that's not doing shit but keeping you in a depressive ass mode. So just keep going, and I love you guys. I'll probably see you guys in my next video, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you like, comment, and subscribe. Guys, if you didn't know, listen to Cleo's soul. She truly cleanses the soul. I just dislocated something on my shoulder. Ugh. But yeah, just listen to some Cleo soul and cleanse that soul of yours, babes, because yeah, just cleanse it. But I'm finna leave right now, so yeah.